Welcome students.
Now today we have taken a topic in your examination point of view. We are going to have a discussion about the starting of various metabolic pathways. In which there is various metabolic pathways we have discussed and we have detailed. It is an important chapter, and we will start with a main reaction of succinic acid pathway. The succinic acid pathway, it has various steps, and also whenever you are writing the succinic acid pathway, please remember you have to write the structure very clearly, because as I told repeatedly, I am telling you, a pharmacy student, you are in the stage of an advanced chemistry, so your structures are very, very important when you are writing, especially bond. And how you mention the substituents and the attachment of the molecules should be clearly mentioned. So, and also here, when you study about the natural chemistry, and this when you are mentioning about biosynthesis, this is biosynthetic pathway, it is must for the students to write clearly about the enzymes and the steps. And we have taken for our discussion today is succinic acid pathway. So first we should know what is succinic acid, and it is a precursor for various aromatic natural compounds. Aromatic compounds need to enter through succinic acid. Various aromatic amino acids, and also you know various aromatic compounds in plants have to pass through succinic acid pathway. So we'll go very slowly and steadily. It's a small topic, it's not a chapter, not like previously I'm going to take, not lengthy, and you can listen clearly and it will be helpful for you. So succinic acid structure, you see, succinic acid, a 6-member ring structure with a double bond, and it has 3 OH groups, and you can see even it has an C double bond O and OH acid, carboxylic acid group. So you can decide the formula very easily, and also you know it is having 3 OH group and also 1 carboxylic acid group. It has 6-membered ring structure with a double bond. So that's what you have to remember about the structure. This is a precursor. From this, various other compounds are formed. So where they, this is just for an information, from where they identified the succinic acid, means plenty of succinic acid is present in succinic, elysium, anisatum is a flower. You may be knowing this one. We are using as a spice in various preparation of biryanis and all these things. We have used this flower. So again, I am repeating, students, please look into the structure of succinic acid. Now, as we study in the synthetic chemistry, here also in biosynthetic pathway, we have to know what all the steps involved to achieve this structure in the plant naturally. That's what we are going to have a discussion. So succinic acid is a precursor for what all things? Number one, aromatic amino acids. So we know that phenylalanine, tyrosine and tryptophan is also, it comes under aromatic compound because it has an aromatic ring structure, a benzene with one and heterocyclic ring, indole. So aromatic compound. So indole, as I told, indole and indole derivatives and aromatic amino acid tryptophan, AAA, aromatic amino acid tryptophan. Is also, if you want to form, you need succinic acid. So succinic acid is the mainstream of, that's why it's called a precursor. Precursor, that's you have to remember, understand? And alkaloids, there are various alkaloids. Aromaticity is there. Even alkaloids, you have studied nitrogen containing compound, may be present inside the ring, or some of them may be outside the ring, but still nitrogen containing compounds is the definition we might have studied in alkaloids. Even in the alkaloids also there is aromaticity. If you see Rauwolfia serpentina, serpentine structure or reserpine structure, even though they are alkaloids which contain heterocyclic ring structure, aromatic compounds, aromatic rings, it's a large compound, aromatic structures will be there. So if you want to achieve that secondary metabolites, it has to undergo succinic acid pathway. So that's what we are explaining about the succinic acid pathway is a precursor for all type of aromatic compounds. And phenyl means aromatic, phenyl propanoids, flavonoids, tannins and lignins, these also very very important compounds which have various therapeutic activity and they need to pass through succinic acid pathway. That's why succinic acid is a precursor for all this type of compounds. Can you follow? So you have to mention the succinic acid is a precursor for aromatic compounds. And now we are just seeing an outline. We made it into two slides I made for continuous reaction and then each reaction with the enzyme I have explained to know. See, first one, what is the structure? You have to write the structure very clearly, please. Write the bond, write clearly, straight, practice, very important. As I told some of them yesterday, I was just telling them about the structures who have written in synconin, synconidin and quinine and quinidine, how they are formula is similar and they are isomers, and we discussed and most of them they were writing about that and in the record. So it's very important. Some of them, they did not put double bonds and they did not write the six-membered ring properly. So I was explaining them, please make it clear to write a structure, the number of the ring structure as well as the bond plays a major role for an identification of a structure. So it's very important for you to be careful to write a chemical structures. So here you see erythrose 4-phosphate. So erythrose 4-phosphate, erythrose, that means it is tetrose. How many carbon atom? It's a sugar molecule. You see that erythrose, it has 4 carbon atom. That's why it is called tetrose. And in the 4th position, you can see that it has a phosphate. PO3H2 is attached with that carbon atom. So you can see erythrose 4 phosphate, 4 carbon atom compound. When it is added with, it is combining with a phosphoenol pyruvate. So phosphoenol pyruvate, the students may be knowing about the pyruvic acid. Pyruvic acid. When you study biochemistry in your citric acid cycle, before citric acid cycle, you might have studied a glucose molecule undergo glycolysis to give 2 molecules of pyruvic acid. So, in the what is the biochemistry of, even in the plant biochemistry also same. So when you see, it is also having the pyruvic acid. So the pyruvate, the phospho PO3H2, you can see the structure there very clearly. Phosphoenol pyruvate. What do you mean by enol? Every word you should know. You should know about your basic chemistry. Enol. Enol, double bond CH2. Otherwise there will be an OH group. You might have studied that. And if you see that, what is the enolic form of vitamin C, ascorbic acid, you might have studied in your chemistry, ascorbic acid have enol form and also a tartaric, and also it has a tartaric form. So same like acids and also alcohols, you can have these type of enolic form. You should know that lactic acid, ascorbic acid, pyruvic acid, they can be written in the form of enolic form. So here the enolic form with phosphate, that's why it is called phosphoenol pyruvate. When they combine together, pyruvic acid, how many carbon atom? 3 carbon atom. How many carbon atom is present in the erythrose 4 phosphate? 4 carbon atom. So 4 plus 3, how much? 7 carbon atoms. So you are getting a 7 carbon atom compound, that is called, when 3 and 4 together, you are getting the compound 3-deoxy-d-arabino-heptulo-7, that means 7, heptulonate, 7 phosphate, 7th carbon atom, you are having phosphate. So this is the compound which you got. So you have to remember erythrose 4-phosphate combined with phosphoenol pyruvate to give this 3-deoxy-d-arabino-heptulosinate-7-phosphate. And this compound again converted into by enzymatic action, that is dehydroquinine, 3-dehydroquinine is formed. 3-dehydroquinine, as we have seen, sicamic acid have 3 OH group and 1 COOH group. That's what you have to remember. That's why in the beginning I showed the structure of sicamic acid. So you see here, 3-dehydro, third position a double bond O, and it is said that 3-dehydroquinate or quinic acid, quinate. And this 3-hydroquinate, now it is converted into 3-dehydrosicamate. 1 water, that means 1 OH and 1 hydrogen is removed, water molecule is removed from position number 1, and you are getting a double bond. And what is the name of the structure? 3-dehydrosicamate. we have near to our succinic acid formula. So you see, succinate, you have come to the succinic acid. Now, again, by means of enzymatic action, you are removing again, or you are adding hydrogen. So addition of hydrogen means reduction. So when you are adding hydrogen, addition of hydrogen, you are getting a OH group in the third position, and you are getting the succinic acid. The dehydro is removed and you can, succinate is formed, succinic acid is formed. And this succinic acid is the main succinic acid pathway, and it will undergo one more reaction stating that corosmate or corosmic acid, which is the main precursor to produce most of the compounds, most of the aromatic biological compounds for biosynthesis of various secondary metabolites in the plants. So that's what we are going to see now. Now, individually, this all steps, erythrose 4-phosphate and phosphoenol pyruvate joined to give 7-membered carbon atom compound, which is called heptulacate 7-phosphate, 3-dehydro-4-arabino heptulacate 7-phosphate, and it will be converted into dehydrocunate, and then it is converted to 3-dehydrosicinate, and that one is converted into succinate. So individually we can see what is the enzyme, also very easy for you to remember. What is the product? According to that, just you can write the enzyme very clearly. So the first step, determination of step, succinic acid pathway, what you have seen only we are repeating. See, the enzyme, the same name, 3-dehydro-d-arabino-heptulosinate 7-phosphate synthetase, just you have added synthetase, is the first enzyme in a series for metabolic reaction known as succinate pathway. And since it is the first enzyme, it is the succinate pathway, it controls the amount of the product, amount of the carbon entering the pathway. You see this reaction I have shown again. In that, you can see erythrose 4-phosphate, 4-carbon atom, phosphoenol pyruvate, pyruvic acid in the form of enolic form, double bond CH2, and enzyme 3-deoxy, 3-d-arabino heptulosinate 7-phosphate synthetase is the enzyme. Water molecule is added and removed the phosphate, because 2-phosphate molecules are there in the natural compound, natural reaction. You are getting the 7-membered carbon atom. You see there CH2, CHOH, 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 CH2, C double bond O, and COOH. So you have got 3-deoxy, D-arabino, heptulosinate, 7-carbon atom compound, hepto, and 7-phosphate. And the next step, this one is, again, next product name is, next enzyme, second enzyme is cunate, you remember? So 3-dehydrocunate synthetase is the second enzyme of the succinate pathway. What is the enzyme, second enzyme? According to the product, which succinic acid, you remember succinic acid, before succinic acid, you should have cunic acid, cunate. So 3-dehydroquinate synthetase is a second enzyme of the succinic acid pathway. It catalyzes the elimination of phosphate from the 7-member, that means dehydroarabinoheptulophosphate to generate 3-dehydroquinate. 3-dehydroquinate. See there? The 3-dehydroxy d-arabinoheptulosinate 7-phosphate is converted into 3-dehydroquinate by means of 3-hydroquinate synthetase. So this is also synthetase which has been synthesized by means of NAD, converted into NADH plus in the presence of cobalt ion, which is shown in the reaction. Understand, can you follow? That is what you have to remember. So the enzyme, the product synthesis, very easy for you to remember. Understand? The next one you can see, 3-dehydroquinate. Now the 3-dehydroquinate dehydratase. Here there is no synthetase, that means dehydratase. Cunic acid, you need OH, one more OH, there is a double bond. So we have to make it. So you need, what is the compound? You no need to produce something, you have to dehydratase. So catalyze the third step of the succinic acid pathway. Dehydration of 3-dehydroquinate to 3-dehydrosicimate. It is converted into 3-dehydrosicimate. So it's nearing to our product succinic acid. That's what we have seen. Cunate is converted into succinate. In between, that is 3-dehydrosicimate. You see the structure? The double bond O has to be converted into OH, that is in the next step. But before that, we brought one double bond in the number 1 and 2 carbon atom by means of removing hydrate. That is why dehydratase. Water molecule is removed and you are getting a double bond. And you can see that 3-dehydroquinate is converted into 3-dehydrosicimate. And now succinate 5-dehydrogenase. Succinate 5-dehydrogenase. The fourth step of this succinate pathway is the reduction of dehydrosicimate to succinate, or dehydrosicimate into succinic acid. The reaction is catalyzed by NADP dependent succinate dehydrogenase. So dehydrogenase, NADP is dependent succinate dehydrogenase. You need succinate 5-dehydrogenase is used. You can see that the enzyme is succinate dehydrogenase. It has been NADPH is converted into NADP addition of one hydrogen. So that will give you OH molecule, an addition of OH, and the double bond O is converted into OH, means you need carbon atom present in that junction also should be added with one hydrogen, and also OH also have to be added with one hydrogen. So addition of two molecules of hydrogen. So there is a reduction. NADPH plus hydrogen will give NADP. So that is a reduction takes place and you are getting the succinic acid or D-succinate is the main component. And after this, again the steps go to prefumic acid. That is also today we will just see, that is the important steps for the succinic acid pathway. So what will happen to the succinate now? The succinic acid is again addition of one compound of enol pyruvic acid. enol pyruvic acid. Remember, enol pyruvic acid. CH2, C, COOH, O, P, O3H2. That means phosphate. Otherwise, it will be OH. You know that. It is also having OH and COOH. That is the pyruvic acid. So this is enol pyruvic acid. So pyruvic acid, and when you add it with the succinic acid, they both together, you will get the next step is succinate-3-phosphate. Succinate-3-phosphate. Succinic acid in the third position, you are getting a phosphate is connected with, and a bond aromaticity have been achieved in the compound. And this is now converted to, five enol pyryl succinate 3-phosphate. 5-enol pyryl succinate 3-phosphate. And then that is converted into corrosmate. So you can see that how when you are adding with the succinate 3-phosphate and the phosphoenol pyruvate, you are getting a compound that is 5-enol pyryl succinate 3-phosphate. So just imagine, succinic acid is added with one pyruvic acid, you are getting succinic acid attached with in the fifth position of the OH group of the sec, that is succinic acid is getting attached with the pyruvic acid formula, that is CH2COOH or OCHC CH2C3 carbon atom is getting attached with the linkage of O. Corrosmate is formed. So corrosmate, you can see that corrosmate very clearly, the corrosmate structure in one more bond, only one OH in COOH and OH, and one OCCH2 and COOH, corrosmate or corrosmate. And this is step-wise we are going to detail explanation what we have seen collectively. Succinate kinase in the first step of the succinate pathway, succinate kinase catalyzed the specific phosphorylation of the 3-hydroxy group of D succinate to yield succinate 3-phosphate using ATP as a co-substrate. You see that structure? And here first you are phosphorylating. First step, it is phosphorylated. Which position? The 3-hydroxy group is phosphorylated. So succinate 3-phosphate. And then you are adding with, you are getting 3-enol pyruvic succinate or succinate. How? You are adding 1-enol pyruvate is added. So which enzyme? The product is 5-enol pyruvinyl succinate 3-phosphate synthetase. That is a product. Is the 6th enzyme of succinic acid pathway or succinate pathway. It catalyzes the reversible formation of 5-enol pyrovinyl or pyrovinyl group 3 carbon atom, pyrovinyl 6 sikimate 3 phosphate, from sikimate 3 phosphate and phosphoenol pyruvate. PEP means phosphoenol pyruvate. So you see, sikimate 3 phosphate with combined with a molecule of phosphoenol pyruvate in the presence of enzyme 5-enol pyrovinyl succinate, that sikimate 3 phosphate synthetase, it gives 3-enol pyrovinyl succinyl 3 phosphate. So you are getting attached by O C double bond CH2COOH, and corosmate synthetase, the seventh and the final step in the main trunk of sikimate pathway, is the trans 1,4 elimination of phosphate from that means phosphate from, especially which, what is that, EPS. You can see the EPS is here. You have to E stands for enol pyrovinyl. Here we can enol pyrovinyl succinate 3 phosphate. That means enol pyruvate succinyl phosphate, or it's not succinate, sorry, sikimate phosphate. It yield that corosmate. So in this reaction of phosphate, or in this reaction of this phosphate formation, you can see the second and the third bond of the benzene ring is introduced. So you had only one bond in sikimic acid with 3 OH group and 1 COOH group in the number 1 position, 3, 4, 5 position OH group. Very easy, one bond. So other two bonds, that means you can see that is 3 bonds of the benzene ring is introduced. That is, aromaticity is introduced in this step. So the reaction is catalyzed by corosmate synthetase and requires reduced flavin for activity, even though the overall reaction is redox neutral. Understand? Redox neutral. See the reaction. 5-enol pyrovinyl sikimate 3 phosphate is converted by corosmate synthetase to corosmate with the two bonds and double and O. And when you oxidize it, removal of hydrogen, immediately you will get the other bond of benzene. So this is corosmate is the important step for getting the other products. Understand? So the seventh step of sikimate pathway links the metabolism of carbohydrate to biosynthesis of aromatic amino acids and many aromatic secondary metabolites, including tetrahydrofolate and ubiquinone. This is just a small example. There are many compounds have been formed by means of this sikimic acid pathway. And you see here, I have listed out just for the discussion, sikimic acid can be converted into chorogenic acid, and sikimic acid can be converted into corosmic acid, which we have seen there, and then it can be converted into anthralic acid, and then it can be converted into tryptophan, an aromatic amino acid which is having indole ring structure. And then we'll see from here, and then we'll come here. And then carosmic acid directly converted into phenylalanine, an aromatic amino acid. And tyrosine also. And then you can see the tryptophan can give rise to indole glucosinates, and it can give indole phytoalaxins. Tryptamine can also be formed from tryptophan. Indole alkaloids, quinone alkaloids, these all are formed from this tryptophan. And indole acetic acid is also formed from tryptophan. That is an hormone especially. And phenylalanine can give rise to phenylethylamine and cinnamic acid also, which is present in what you have seen in the last class about cinnamon bark, cinnamic acid also from phenylalanine. Isoquinoline and benzoisoquinolines can also be produced from this phenylalanine and also various other alkaloids from tryptophan also. And cyanogenic glycosides can also be obtained from tyrosine. Beta lines, morphine example. Tyramine can be produced from tyrosine, and also it can also form hordenine. And then you can see from cinnamic acid especially. From cinnamic acid you can get production of flavonoids and anthocyanins. Flavonoids and anthocyanins are produced from especially from cinnamic acid. And cinnamic acid can also give rise to lignin precursors. Coumarins can also be produced from cinnamic acid. Phytoalexins can also be produced from cinnamic acid. And salicylic acid is also produced from cinnamic acid. So see, from cinnamic acid, from salicylic acid you can get catechols, tannins, various flavotannins, salicylates, methyl salicylates, and hydroxybenzoic acid. These all are some of the compounds which we have discussed today. But we have to go for studying about this all. This is just a pathway, succinic acid pathway. So please, students, just remember what we have seen before. It is short form, very, very short form. I will just tell you to remember, first step what you have taken is erythrose 4-phosphate. You can remember, very simple. If I can remember, you can remember more. Erythrose 4-phosphate is added with enol pyruvic acid, or you can say enol phosphate, or you can remember like that at least. Enol pyruvic acid. And when these two are joined, phosphoenol pyruvic acid is having 3 carbon atom. Erythrose 4-phosphate is having 4 carbon atom. When they both are joined together, you are getting 7 carbon atom compound. So what is the name? Heptulosate. You can remember all the other things. Outline, at least you can remember like that. 7 carbon atom. Heptulose phosphatase, a compound which we have got And next step, you can remember what happens. It will get cyclized and you will get cuneate. Okay. So in cuneate, you can remember about dehydration. And it gives 3-dehydro-6-sicimate. And that 3-dehydro-sicimate, remember, you want to make 3 OH groups. There, that water molecule will be removed and it will become double bond. So dehydro-sicimate from cuneate. And then you will get the sicimic acid. So after getting sicimic acid, we have to go to corosmate. Up to corosmate, you have to remember. Very simple. So sicimate, you corosmate, you need another 3 carbon atom compound should be attached and a double bonds should be there. So you have to add one more enol phosphoenol pyruvate. Before that, you want to phosphorylate the sicimic acid and add with a phosphoenol pyruvate, and you will get a enol pyruvyl, a corosmate, and then when you are next step itself, immediately you are getting the 7th step, corosmate. Corosmate, which is having the aromaticity by means of having the 3 bonds can be obtained by means of reduction, and you will get the corosmate. And the corosmate can give rise to anthralic acid and various compounds which you have listed out here. So just you can, what I have said now, even it is possible for you to just to see these steps, what I have told. See here, remember, erythrose 4-phosphate added with a phosphoenol pyruvate gives the 7-membered carbon atom compound heptulosate, and the 3-dehydrocuneate is converted into 3-dehydrosicimate, and that makes the sicimic acid. And when we come to the continuation, this sicimate is added with phosphorylated, first sicimate 3-phosphate, and then it is added with the, which I have shown, the plus should be here, and here it is shown that side, it should be here, added with the phosphoenol pyruvate, and that gives 5-enol pyruvyl succinate 3-phosphate, and that gives you the corosmate. The last step is corosmate. So that's what we are told here. The 7th step is corosmate synthesis, which is produced by means of corosmate synthesis. So that's what you have to remember, where the trans 1,4 elimination of phosphate from enol pyruvyl sicimate phosphate is yield as corosmate. So you should know that the 7th step of sicimic acid pathway links the metabolism of carbohydrate to the biosynthesis of aromatic amino acid and many aromatic secondary metabolites, including tetrahydrofolate and ubiquinone and many other compounds which we have discussed today. Thank you. We will continue in the next class.